Mars. We don't want to go there. It's been a long, long time. Rocket Man, Elton John. Hello, vloggers.
Hi, vloggers. Today is October 11th. Thursday, 2007. Do we have any idea? We don't know the countdown, but...
It's like 9 more days. It's whatever, 1 year, 3 months, and like 9 days, I think it is.
We're on the road, so we don't have access to the internet.
We're going to get a broadband card one day. We'll let you know when we do.
But today we're on we're heading up the Florida Turnpike, going to get onto Route 75 in just a few moments. We're almost up to the Georgia border. And we're going to travel on up to the Atlanta area and hang out tonight, because tomorrow we have business. And then tomorrow night we're heading to see your family.
Yeah, we're going to have a quick little din-din with everyone.
Tell them who.
My sister and my parents and my uncle and my cousins from Germany are going to be there, so.
And Pete and your nieces.
And Pete. Well, that's my sister and her family.
Yeah.
Should I not say that?
I don't know.
I thought I did.
Gotten some nice comments from people. Gina was sent a comment talking about she got to go see Tori Amos.
Right.
Concert. That must have been fun. I'm not a big concert person.
Yeah, we're not very concert-oriented. People.
Well, I don't know whether it's different as much anymore, but back, I remember seeing Bruce Springsteen one time, and the music's just not very good. I mean, the sound is not great. I guess it's kind of the whole atmosphere and stuff.
Yeah, but I don't know.
But I can understand why people who are big fans of someone, I've seen some great concerts in terms of, you know, like Barry Manilow and Bette Midler. I know. I'm a geek.
I've never been to a concert, but... The idea kind of scares me. Just a lot of people. I'm not a crowd person, so I tend to freak out around crowds.
Yeah, we both don't do well with that. That's a nice comment from Rebecca.
Right.
Lots of people are watching, I assume. I hope.
I hope. I hope you're still out there, people.
Well, we haven't been too about posting lately.
Well, with getting home and getting ready and working and getting ready to go...
Well, last time I think we talked, we were talking about Ginger was going in to have surgery, and she did on Monday. She came out of it fine. She's right. Got a big scar on her leg.
Yeah.
But she's okay.
Makes me nervous to leave her. I know she's fine, but it just makes me nervous.
We have pet sitters come in and look after her.
So, she still has to take medicine, so the pet sitter has to do the medicine.
Yep. Yep.
What else is going on in the world?
I don't know. It was interesting watching that interview last night on The Daily Show with Jon Stewart. He had Lynn Cheney on.
Ugh.
And, you know, you could tell that he was just so uncomfortable because it wasn't proper for him to say what he wanted to say about her husband. But,
Well, and then they had that one segment that they changed from You Don't Know, and they would, you know, use the short name for his name. And, then they changed it last night to You Don't Know Richard Cheney. And it was all these, like, nice things about him.
Well, I think it's fascinating that she chose to go on. I mean, you know, the thing that I find interesting about the Republicans is if it's going to make them money, they can handle the liberal media at that point.
Well, yeah.
Because she's on there
That's
selling
like
a book.
O'Reilly, when he has a book, he'll go on and hawk it to everybody.
Absolutely. Yeah. Crazy. So, what else? We had a rehearsal yesterday at the hotel. You stayed home because you were getting us ready for our travels. But I actually had a good time. I saw Miles and Kirsten and the whole gang down at the hotel and made some fun yesterday afternoon. It was nice.
Well then,
do you want to tell a little bit about what we're heading up to do this weekend?
Oh, we're working on the rock project, and we are working on guest service, inspirational type of seminar type thing.
Yeah, it's designed to motivate employees to be excited about this upcoming holiday season.
With guest interactions and, you know, saying thank you. My pleasure, come again, all that good southern down home feeling.
The golden rule kind of thing. What else has been going on in politics? It seems like there's been things going. Of course, Fred Thompson's...
The Republican National... or not National. The Republicans had their debate thing.
And Fred Thompson joined them this time.
Yes, he was there.
And he's pretty unimpressive.
Yep.
Isn't it interesting that it could very well come down to a race between Hillary and Rudy, which was foreshadowed some years ago when she originally ran for the Senate race, but then he dropped out because of he had some sort of cancer scare.
9/11? Oh, sorry.
No, it was after 9/11. He had gotten...
9/11. John Stewart says that he has 9/11 Tourette's. He can't stop using that, like, every time he talks.
Yeah. People do like to scare us. What were we watching on TV this morning that they were trying to scare you about? And it's like, oh my goodness.
No, it's on the news. Something about...
Something about computers and... if you're in a hotel, if you, use a public computer, they have these systems that people can come in and connect it to the computer, to the tower, and then basically it
tracks
records...
any keyboard press... Anything you press on the
keystroke.
Copies in a file.
Yeah.
And then someone can go in and see what everything that you typed in. Well, yeah, well, you could also be in a car accident.
Yeah, it was a little bit ridiculous. But I mean, I guess you have to be cautious about everything. But man, the news really is lame. And because this whole thing is going on so long with the candidates, they keep saying the same thing over and over again.
Can you tell what their position is by the way they're wearing their tie?
They talked about that today with their clothing.
So disgusting.
Yeah, it's pretty silly.
So,
but we've still been enjoying a little free time, even though we're now heading out on the road. I'm glad to kind of be getting out and doing something.
I am too. And then I'll see my family and catch up with them, see how they're doing.
Didn't we have such a good time last Sunday at SeaWorld? You know, we've mentioned it before, but to, you know, our dear friend Michael, thank you for making that such a nice day for us.
That was so much fun.
I hope other people enjoyed seeing the video, see some of the cool things.
So cool.
It's amazing, those animals. Just amazing.
Very neat.
Yep. And,
I don't know when we'll get to post this. We're gonna try maybe, like, go into a
Starbucks
or, somewhere, Panera Bread or something along the way and upload. We'll see how it goes.
Yeah, we made this a day of travel so we wouldn't have to stress out too much. We didn't get on the road very quickly this morning, and, I went first and got the tires rotated and the car all serviced so we could get on the road.
And here we are.
And here we are.
On the road again.
At Suwannee, right near the Suwannee River. Suwannee, how I love you, how I love you.
Way down yonder on the Suwannee River.
My sister Linda came down to visit last weekend to see my family, and that sounded like that was fun. I don't know if anybody got to take a look over at my niece Marnie, her blog.
So cute.
It was really funny because I was making a fuss about the fact that there was no picture of me with Augie. So she's done all of these Photoshop things with Augie and I, as if we're on a world tour.
That was so funny.
It was funny. My niece, like, Marnie, has a great sense of humor.
I was cracking up the other day. I was like, I opened it up, and as soon as it opened up, like, you even heard me, like, wailing.
Yeah.
Laughing so hard.
She, you know, she would make a remarkable,
like a satirist or a...
Yeah, a comedy writer or, and she's really, I mean, she's got a great wit about her. She always has, actually.
Well then, about 45 seconds or something like that.
Oh, good.
So,
yeah, we're going to take it easy and listen to Broadway show tunes for the rest of this afternoon.
Yeah.
Sing full out. We're also working on a script as we're going up here. You're doing some diagrams and some graphics and stuff.
Yeah. I'm trying to get some stuff done on the road. It's not easy in the car, though. It's a little hard to type, but we manage.
49 miles to Valdosta, everyone.
Valdosta.
Valdosta. Forgive me.
All right, well, have a marvelous day wherever you are.
We'll talk to you from Atlanta.
Later.
Bye.